because he knew he was going to be in sin.
Oh, yeah. Right.
For God so loved the world, talking about you and me, that he did something about it.
Amen.
He sent us a remedy.
Yes, he did.
You know, if you got a cold, bad cold, what you do, you take a little cough syrup because you feel that that's the remedy for your cold.
Right.
If somebody got pneumonia, the doctor gonna give some antibiotics because he said that's a remedy for the pneumonia that's all in the lungs.
Yeah, yeah.
So the person can get healed from it.
Amen.
If you want to get healed from your sin-sick soul, this word will do it.
Amen. Yes, it
you
will.
You want to get healed from depression, this
yes.
word will do it.
Yes, it will.
If you don't want to go to hell, this world will save you.
Yes.
But guess what? The one that rejects God, the same word is going to condemn you.
Yes, that's true.
Amen, praise God.
Yes.
So it's how we hear the word, how we receive the word, mm-hmm. that matters.
Mm-hmm.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son.
That's right, amen.
That whosoever believeth in him should not perish.
Mm-hmm.
Now see, if God sent this word so that we won't perish, do you mean if I don't receive your Son, I will perish?
Mm-hmm.
Separated from God throughout eternity.
God.
A lot of people don't understand when you go to a funeral, you see the body that's laying out there before everybody going back. Oh, that's such a nice dress. Oh, that casket was really nice.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. And the preacher up there preaching the person in hell. And you know they died of fornication. They had a woman that's too young.
Amen.
Had a heart attack battle.
Oh,
that's right.
You know, I'm just being real
that's
about
right, that's
these
right.
things happen.
It does.
Amen. Or the person died with a needle stuck up in their arm.
Mm.
But yet now you preaching them in heaven.
Mm.
I'm going to tell you something about Leaking Sons' work. They do excellent work.
Mm-hmm.
They make their body look so pretty.
Amen.
They do excellent work to the remains.
Amen. Amen.
See, that's all you look at is the remains.
Right.
Because when God called that spirit and soul out that person,
all right. Come on now.
That person is gone.
Right.
They no longer exist down here on this earth.
Yes.
Now they got to give an account to God.
Yes. Yes.
For the life that they lived here on this earth.
Amen.
Amen.
You, everybody in here.
Yes.
One day. All the way down to that little baby there.
Mm-hmm.
We all. Got to give an account to the life that we live.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
We sit here today, but we've got to prepare ourselves for tomorrow.
That's right. Come on now.
Amen. Because we don't know where God is going to call us home. But we got to be ready.
Yes.
We got to be always be ready. We got to learn to live each day like it's our last.
That's right. Come on now.
We don't know. Look at the signs.
Oh, my God.
Do you see the handwriting on the wall?
Yes, yes.
My God, my God. Look at all the disasters that we've never, ever heard of before happening.
Amen.
That's happened.
Amen.
It's letting us warning us. Turn to God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Look at all the hideous crimes that's going on. How people are murdering and killing people. They'll sit right there in their house. And the body is dead, and they'll go in the refrigerator and cook their food and eat.
Amen.
No remorse.
Wax
some
worse
and worse.
Sons and daughters, they're killing their parents. No remorse. Mothers are killing their children, selling them as sex slaves or for a bag of dope.
Hammers.
Come on.
These things are happening.
Every day.
You might say, well, why God let these things happen? First of all, God made us all free moral agents.
Yes. That's right.
We have a will to serve God, to live for him.
Yes.
And if you don't choose to live for God, guess what? Guess who your dad is? The devil.
Amen.
Satan.
Amen.
And the lust of their father, they shall do.
Amen. True.
We don't have no power over Satan within our own self. Only by the power and the spirit of Christ on
that's
the inside.
Right.
The spirit of God is what gives us the power to be able to resist the works of sin.
Yes.
The works of Satan.
Yes.
Gives us power and authority over these demons.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Remember, Jesus is our remedy.
Yes.
He's our way out.
Yes.
You want to have a prosperous life? It's only in God.
Amen.
I heard this, my little sister read a scripture about fret not thyself because of evildoers. Neither be thou envious against the wicked, the workers of iniquity, but they shall be soon cast.
Come on,
now see, you see people, and you know they ain't living nothing.
Come on.
But see, now, ooh, they busting out with these nice fine cars.
Yes.
You know they selling drugs.
Right.
You know they con artists. Oh, got the best looking house on the block. My God. Doing all kind of wicked and evil things. The Bible says, don't you fret not.
Amen.
So get stirred up about what Satan is doing over
right,
there.
Right, right.
It's a trap.
Yes.
It's to get your mind off of God.
Amen. That's so true.
See, the Bible lets us know that God gives us perfect peace whose mind stayed on him.
Amen. That's right.
That's the only way we can have perfect peace. We got to keep our minds on him.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Because the very minute that you don't have your mind on God, enemy is trying to steal from you.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
God can bless you in a service, a dynamite service, and before you get up out of there good, the enemy trying to steal.
Oh, yeah.
He's a thief.
That's right.
He's a thief.
Yes.
He don't want us to hold on to nothing
right.
that God has given to us.
Right, Amen. Right.
But on today, God wants us. My God,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, to walk in total victory in him. Amen, praise God. He wants to trust in him. My God, we're going to get into the word. Amen, praise God. Thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's go to Matthew 11 and 29.
Yeah.
Glory to God, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, I bless your name, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Matthew 11 and 29. It reads, 28, I'm sorry. Come. When somebody say come, what is that? That's an invitation, right? That means that whoever is saying come, they want you to, they invite you to participate in something.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
They got you on their mind.
Mm-hmm.
I want to let you know God got you on his mind.
All right, amen.
None of us are here haphazardly, so because we thought that it was just in my mind to do it.
Mm-hmm.
God knows how.
That's it.
To give us thoughts.
Yes.
And to work out and orchestrate.
Yes.
Our going.
That's
and
right.
Our coming.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you,
glory to God. It says, come. This is Jesus saying, come unto me. Now, I want you to just, in your mind, just visualize the Lord just talking to you, just personally, because this is a personal thing.
Mm-hmm.
Shut anything out and anybody listen. Come unto me. Hallelujah. All ye that labor and are heavy burden. Hallelujah. And I will give you rest.
Oh
God. Oh God. Thank you, Jesus.
Okay.
God want to give you rest on today.
Yes, Lord. Thank
Lord, in the name of Jesus. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. God's yoke is his teachings. He wants us to learn his ways. In order to please God, we have to begin to learn how. That's why the word of God tells us that God says, I give pastors according to my heart to feed my sheep with knowledge and understanding. Everybody cannot teach God's people. Everybody has not been anointed to teach God's people. Everyone has not been anointed to go out and preach, period. But there are many people that went on their own accord And not only have they made shipwreck of their life, but they're shipwrecking lives of others. The Bible says the blind lead the blind, and they all fall in the ditch.
Amen.
Amen. Amen, praise God.
Amen.
But this is the greatest invitation anybody could have.
Yeah.
It's nice to be invited to a wedding. That's nice. It's real nice. It's nice to be invited to graduations.
Amen.
But this is the greatest invitation anyone could possibly receive.
Amen.
It's an invitation to be able to just lay out everything that's not my God.
Amen.
And to receive him into your life.
That's right.
The Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature.
Hallelujah.
Old things are passed away.
Amen.
Behold, all things become new. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. And he promised this to you.
Yes,
I will give you this.
Amen.
That's a promise, man. That's a promise.
Take my yoke, which is my teachings, upon you. Learn of me. For I am meek.
Amen.
And lowly in heart. And he promises this. And ye shall find rest unto your soul.
Amen.
For my yoke is easy. And my burden is light.
That's right.
Oh God, hallelujah.
I'm a witness.
My God. My God.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah.
Holy, holy.
He wants us to get into a place of rest in him. See, when you receive God's rest, amen, praise God, you're able to enjoy God's security.
Amen.
With no fear.